Hello friends, it's me, Sarah. Today I'm going to be sharing with you my very first official Halloween Samhain altar. Y'all, I need more reverence in my holidays. Don't get me wrong, I love Halloween. I have always loved Halloween. In fact, if you ask anybody who knows me, they would probably tell you I'm obsessed with Halloween. And not quite. I don't celebrate it all year long like a lot of people do, but I do love it. It's one of my favorite times of year. But for the past few years, something's been missing. I've been feeling a lot less connected to Halloween. And I think the reason for that is that we've lost reverence for the holiday. It is probably the oldest holiday that we still celebrate today, and started over 2,000 years ago with the ancient Celts of Ireland. It was considered one of the most magical days of the year, where the veil between our living physical world and the ethereal spiritual realm was at its thinnest. It marked the end of the harvest season and the beginning of winter, which was a very scary time considering all the food you had was all the food you were gonna get. And it is one of many other celebrations from around the world, a day to honor our ancestors and our loved ones who had passed during the last year. But today, it seems like all it really is a day to eat candy, go trick-or-treating, and for adults to get drunk in costume. And that's fine, that's great. Halloween is supposed to be fun. It's supposed to be a day to let loose, to just play, to step into a different version of yourself, to get close to the things that scare you, to challenge your fears, and do things that are exciting or just things that you wouldn't normally do. But sometimes I feel like Winifred Sanderson when she realizes what Halloween has become. Just being honest. So I figured, what a better way to reconnect with the ancient roots of this most magical holiday and create my own Halloween Samhain altar. So I'm going to take you along as I gather supplies and just take you on a little tour of the altar itself. I hope you enjoy.
I found an egg.
You did? Put it in your basket. Yeah, it's made from pomegranate wood.
Pomegranate wood?
Mm-hmm. What do you got?
Something for Otto.
What's in there?
I mean, they're jewels.
They're jewels?
Yeah.
This is, oops, carnelian. Is it carnelian?
Carnelian. Mm-hmm.
This is obsidian. Don't peel that off, please. This is your great grandma's Just Do It rock. Here's some, oops. Amethyst. Say amethyst.
Amethyst.
Another amethyst.
A new amethyst.
Yeah. Oops. And lots of little carnelians.
Yeah, dear carnelians.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Okay, so I just want to take a second and show you this. This is actually a very, very old family Bible. It's very delicate. Ooh, I should probably put this up on The altar. Totally forgot this was in here. This is my great-great-grandfather, I think. So he can go on the altar, but this is in here. You can see it's from, let's see if I can get closer, 1868. So this is about 150 years old. And it's so cool. But the coolest thing is over here, I'm not sure who did this, but there's all these old obituaries. I don't know who these people are. I don't know if whoever owned this Bible in the past knew these people, or if these people are part of our family. Gosh, old obituaries were so beautiful. But I just thought this is a perfect thing to add to our altar to honor not only my very old ancestors, but, you know, here's some other people's ancestors. Who knows whose family these people belong to? But yeah, so that's why this is part of my altar. I had actually seen this done in another Samhain altar video and thought what a fun activity for Rowan and I to do together, taking some of the leaves that we collected in our backyard and painting them. Now, Samhain is also considered to be the witch's new year. It's the last night of the year and a perfect night to cast any spells, set any intentions, or just make any prayers for the future. So while we painted, we held the intentions for what we wish to bring in the coming year. Health and prosperity for our family, a new home, any goals, any dreams, just whatever we want to see happen when the sun returns. So we finally have my mom's cabinet back in the living room. I missed having it in here. When she was 19 years old, she took a furniture restoration class and she restored this. She took the whole thing apart, sanded it, refinished it, and put it all back together again because she's amazing. I'm very excited to have our very first official Halloween Samhain altar on my mother's cabinet. So here's the before, and
sowing, let the ritual begin. Call upon our sacred ancestors to come in. So
okay, so first let's back up. We've got our pumpkins on top and our giant raven. Ravens are messengers. It's good to lay a nice dark cloth, anything rich, black, purple, deep reds, any deep rich colors are a good thing to use. Pumpkins. Now, I usually only light these maybe once a year, but I'm lighting them just for you guys. Got my favorite deck of tarot cards and some amethyst. Amethyst is good for divination. And this little lady, we got it at an upcycle fair. Adrian and I both feel like she's got this very fierce motherly protective instinct. So she is here to protect us from anything dark or evil that might want to come, and she's just here for our protection. We've got my grandparents, both passed many years ago. We've got a cauldron, more pumpkins. This is our pomegranate stick, our oak stick, a little bit of sage, all of our stones. I've got my gorgeous fairy throne here, which you may have seen in my dresser declutter video. She's got a prominent place here because Samhain night, Halloween night, the portal is open to all the fairy folk, so I am inviting her in to our altar. On top, we've got our Bible. My family Bible for protection and to honor our ancestors. We've got a basket full of offerings. This is probably one of the few things that we grew from our garden. This is our spaghetti squash, a little piece of sad little corn, but it's what we have to offer. An apple that I bought at the store. We've got our oak leaves, our acorns, our little basket of offerings. Got our painted wishing leaves. Rowan's will be in there. They're just still drying outside because they had a lot of paint on them. But I wanted to hurry up and get this filmed before I ran out of light. And we've got a crow. Crows are also said to ferry souls back to earth. We've got our chalice. It's always good to have a chalice. You can probably hear Rowan singing Let It Go in the background. We've got our chalice here. It's always good to have a chalice you can fill with either mulled wine or cider. Just another offering to the spirits, to ancestors, to our loved ones. This is Adrian's grandma and grandpa. And I have a few other pictures that I want to put on here still. I just need to track them down. Got my fairy tarot, again for the fairies. Gold is also another really good color for your Samhain altar. And this candle, this is double duty here, because this candle actually belonged to my great-grandmother. And I usually only light this a few times a year. I have had this for a very long time. I light it on the winter solstice. I light it on New Year's Eve. And now I will light it on Samhain. It's gorgeous. There's actual gold leaf embedded in the wax. And we've got a little fairy here to invite the fairies in again. But here she is. This is our Samhain altar. So I hope you enjoyed seeing my first official Samhain Halloween / Halloween altar. I think that especially this year, since the kids can't go trick-or-treating and since we're not having Halloween parties, it's a really wonderful time to reconnect to the ancient roots of the holiday, to really connect to the magic of it and have more reverence for these moments in our lives. Make them more special, make them even grander, more magical, more exciting, more interesting. And I have to say it on a more somber note, we have to consider the fact that this year is very different and we have lost and we have all experienced so much loss. And there's nothing wrong with connecting with that. There is true beauty in connecting with that. But to avoid getting too emotional right now, I'm going to end it there and ask, do you have a Samhain altar? Do you have a Halloween altar or just a place in your house where you honor the holiday? And ask, do you have your own Halloween altar in your home? If so, I would love for you to tell me what's on it. Or do you plan to make one in your own home? Or does your family's culture have its own holiday to celebrate the ancestors and loved ones who have passed on? Do you feel like you need more reverence in your holidays? I wanna know. Let's talk about stuff down below in the comments. I love to chat with you guys. I love to get to know you, know who's watching, and just make friends. That's what I'm here to do. I'm not here to just hear myself talk. Okay, maybe a little bit. But anyway, thank you for being here. Thank you for listening. Have a beautiful day. Okay, bye.